The US Army has contacted Raytheon to start developing a new 155mm ramjet-powered long-range artillery round. Raytheon will work with the Netherlands Organization for Applied Scientific Research for this project. The idea is to develop a shell that can hit a target 60 miles or 95 kilometers away. On May 1, 2020, Raytheon announced it had received $7.9 million from the Army to get started on the ramjet artillery shell, also referred to as the XM-1155. The Netherlands Organization for Applied Scientific Research will be responsible for developing the ramjet engine. Raytheon will be responsible for integrating the ramjet engine into the rest of the projectile, which it will design and manufacture. Viewers may note that this project is one of the many that's being initiated for future long-range 155mm howitzers. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how US Army plans to deploy ramjet-powered shell to counter China and Russia. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder, the most comprehensive military vehicle online game for PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, in which you can go to battle on more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s. The game has an amazing attention to detail and focuses on a realistic combat experience, which is why knowing your vehicles and skill really makes a difference. It's easy to get into, and all you need to play is nothing more but your mouse and keyboard or controller. Immerse yourself in cross-platform combat with more than 20 million other military vehicle enthusiasts from all over the world. Download and play War Thunder for free using the link in the description below, and also get a free bonus tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account. Artillery was important in the past and will continue to be relevant in the foreseeable future. An artillery barrage not only provides cover for the infantry to advance, but modern artillery can land precise fire on high-value tactical targets on the battlefield. It's cheaper and faster than air support, making them an indispensable asset for any modern army. Hence, all major military powers are continuing to put effort to develop better artillery that can fire further and more accurately. Russian Army deploys 2S-19 MSTA howitzer, which has a range of 15 miles or around 25 kilometers. It entered service in the late 1980s. Now an upgraded variant, 2S-33 MSTA SM-2, is being produced and deployed. The new howitzer has a 2A-79 172mm cannon that's capable of hitting targets at ranges of up to 25 miles or 40 kilometers. Sometime back, General John Murray, commanding general of the Army Futures Command, had told reporters at the Association of the United States Army annual symposium, "The Russian and Chinese have been able to outrange most of our systems." He added, "In Ukraine, we saw the pairing of drones with artillery, using drones as spotters. Their organizational structure and tactics were a wake-up call for us to start looking at a more serious strategy." The powerful Senate Armed Services Committee Chairman, Senator Jim Inhofe, a Republican from Oklahoma, had told Defense News in 2018, "I'm concerned that we're currently behind China and Russia, both in terms of range and rate of fire. During the 8 years of President Barack Obama, we fell behind. We delayed maintenance and deferred modernization, all while China and Russia were improving their conventional forces and artillery. We don't have the best of everything right now, and I want to make sure we can get the best equipment for our warfighters so they don't face a situation where they're outranged or outgunned." Keeping this in view, US Army has been working to fill this gap. The US Army has successfully fired two different munitions from its new extended-range cannon for the M109 howitzer. According to Brigadier General John Rafferty, who's in charge of long-range precision fires modernization, the US Army took two shots from its ERCA, or Extended Range Cannon Artillery, system, which both reached 40 miles or around 65 kilometers in range and hit their intended targets in a demonstration at Yuma Proving Grounds, Arizona, on March 6th. Viewers may note that long-range artillery is one of the US Army's top priorities. This marks a significant technical leap as currently most artillery fires from an M777 towed howitzer or self-propelled howitzer are able to hit targets at a maximum distance of 18.5 miles or 30 kilometers. Presently, U.S. Army uses 227mm guided rockets to hit targets at distances at a range of 40 miles or 65 kilometers. According to Raytheon's press release, the tactical 155mm XM1155 will be able to strike moving and stationary high-value targets on land and at sea. The maneuverable and extended-range airframe will be compatible with legacy and future 155mm artillery systems. The important detail is that the shell is expected to take on moving targets and can be used with normal 155mm artillery systems. As of now, Raytheon did not offer any specific details about the technical aspects. Viewers may note that for a ramjet engine to work, the shell first needs to attend an optimal velocity. This is generally done by employing a rocket booster that provides this initial burst of speed. Once this initial speed is attained, the ramjet engine will kick in and the shell will be able to travel at supersonic speed with reduced drag. This reduction in drag will enable longer range. Raytheon stated that it would leverage its past experience with the M982 Excalibur precision-guided 155mm artillery shell. The Excalibur, which the U.S. Army and U.S. Marines have been using for more than a decade, is capable of hitting stationary targets using its GPS-assisted inertial navigation system, INS, guidance package. The M982 has a maximum range of 20 miles, or 32 kilometers. The XM1155s will obviously need a much more robust guidance system package. The projectile will probably use a multi-mode guidance package. It could include GPS INS guidance to get to the target area and then switch over to radar or imaging infrared to find and then hit the target. This kind of arrangement will mean that the shell will be able to hit the stationary target without any modification using the GPS INS guidance alone. With this kind of arrangement, the U.S. military will have a very flexible weapon in its hands. The area coverage will be increased to a great extent too. For example, XM1113 155mm shells that can strike 40 miles away have the ability to cover an area of 5,026 square miles, whereas the new shell will have a coverage of 11,310 square miles. So tactically, it's a major step forward. Currently, divisions supporting brigade combat teams have to call on rocket forces or air power to deliver firepower at 40 miles or 65 kilometers. This increases the response time, which can be the difference between life and death, or winning and losing. The new shell will negate this kind of thing, and a significant operational edge will be gained. A longer-range cannon will make the U.S. military more agile in the fast-paced modern battlefield. A 60 miles or 95 kilometer equipped cannon will substantially outrange the 25 miles or 40 kilometer MSTAS Russian howitzer. In some aspects, Russian and Chinese systems have evolved to an extent that they're at par with U.S. counterparts or even surpass them in capacity. Through programs like this, the American military is plugging these holes. A variant of this shell, small in size, could also be developed later to arm U.S. Navy warships like the Arleigh Burke-class destroyers and Ticonderoga-class cruisers. It's important to note that the U.S. Navy has more than 65 Arleigh Burke-class destroyers and 22 Ticonderoga-class cruisers in active service. Also, the U.S. military is working on two other systems with the aim of having extended range firing ability. These are hypervelocity projectiles, HVP, and railguns. It remains to be seen how things pan out in the coming days.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.